Yes.
What's going on, everyone? Reg, Prost, coming in here smoking the Emilio Cappuccino. Killer cigar.
Like got this ancho chili kind of zing, earthiness, a lot of sweetness going on.
PBR dude, always treating you good.
Happy to me.
Hope everyone's doing good out there. This is episode 7 of the Goulash. Come in here, maybe Goulash, Austrian Goulash,
and grow.
Bloom and grow. The difference is Hungarian's a little bit more soupy. Austrian's a little bit more like a stew. I like it a little bit thicker, kind of like I like my women. Prost. We're gonna get into this here. First step is you want to make sure that pan's hot. Oh, it is hot. You know how we do it? We're coming in with some of that early morning hog fat, coming right down in there. You gotta have pork fat. And we are doing this kind of the old school way. You'd be doing it out in the backyard or your farmland. We're gonna wanna let that melt. We're using pork fat because it's going to have that high temp. Now that oil's kind of warmed up, goulash, we got a 1-to-1 ratio meat and onions. Dropping all them onions down in there. And that right there, that's one large sweet onion. Make sure you always got a beer in hand when you're making the goulash. And we're out here doing it on the grill, like I said, because you go way back into the Austro-Hungarian Empire, even in the late 1800s, you know, if you were a farmer, you were outside, maybe inside, you could have been making that goulash over the fire like we're doing here today. Want to give a big shout out to Andy over at Smoker Spot. I'm dedicating this recipe to him. Hope you enjoy it. We're gonna wanna get some nice caramelization on all these onions. What's going on, everyone? You know, I really go ahead, I really love. What's going on, everyone? Prost. These onions are just sitting back, they're caramelizing right now. I thought I'd come in. This recipe I'm doing right now, this is my grandma's. Man, I remember, you know, being super young and enjoying the goulash and the chicken peppercosh and the roulade and sauerbraten and another great just rooted German meals. You know, and I remember cooking with her from a young age and just loving it. And I have my cooking to thank to my mom. You know, I remember my mom, I asked my mom one time, I said, I'd like some macaroni and cheese. You know, I was younger and she made some macaroni and cheese and it was fucking hideous. It was terrible. It was, I mean, you could get a fucking raccoon and eat that shit. A dying man wouldn't eat it. And I told her, I said, this is terrible. She looked at me and she said, you don't like it? Get in that kitchen and cook it yourself. And I was like, man, I was real young. And then I'm like, oh man, I was started hanging with my grandma, you know, and watching her cook and helping her out. And that's where my love for cooking came, you know. But I mean, it's like dropped in that motherfucker. It's like hard love, tough love, man. stay tuned to see how these onions turn out.
Okay, we are back. These onions have been slow cooking down in that early morning hog fat for about 35 minutes, and right there, that is how they look. All that sweet caramelization, the sugars are coming out. That is what we want. Right here, we got 1 pound beef tenderloin cubed up. You know, when back in the day, you go way back into the early 1900s, late 1800s with the goulash, you weren't using a beef tenderloin, man. You couldn't afford it. Unless you were slaughtering your own cattle, horses, whatever you had. You know, you could, normal people even use a chuck roast, but I just happen to have this. So now, somebody's probably out here saying, Wrench, you didn't saute that meat up, you didn't flour it, you didn't get any crispiness on there, and them brown bits. Well, you know, you gotta look at it. Back in the day, they didn't know about that brown bits and crispiness. So what we did right here is we are keeping it as close to original gangster goulash as we can get. Now we're gonna wanna do, we got all that in there and that meat's cooking, onions are in there. Now it's time to season. We got that black pepper. Got that black pepper going in. Where is the... Got the salt. And that's that coarse gallon rock salt. Anyone who knows Sinful Delights knows I love that. Now, marjoram. Marjoram's going in. Now we got the caraway seed. And the star of the show, paprika. We wanted a little extra spice, so we got to use a little bit more. Woo! You know, a little bit more. Now we're going to get in there, we're going to stir all that up. And if anybody's wondering what I'm cooking this on, this is a mixture of charcoal and lump hickory wood, because back in the day there would have been a lot of just wood. You wouldn't have had charcoal back in the late 1800s, so I am not using it. And since we like a bit more of a goulash stew, we like it a bit thicker, we're gonna throw a little flour in here. Throw just a little bit more. Because we did have a good portion of bacon fat in there. And that's just gonna suck up into that bacon fat. Make it a little less greasy. And what happens is when you got that heat on those spices, you put a little toast in there. And when you're toasting them spices, I mean it's second to heaven. And then we also cook a little bit of the rawness out of that flour. And that beef tenderloin is so goddamn tender. You cannot beat it. Now, got the beef stock. And I got a little beef stock left over because this is going to sit in this grill here. And this is going to cook slow and low for about 2.5, probably 3 hours. And that sauce is going to come together. It's going to cook down. And we are going to have a sexy finished product. See that beautiful red color? That is what we want. Get those spices off that. Get them back in there. Now it's time to slow cook.
You know, be real honest with you, everybody. I gotta come back in. I fucked up. I almost forgot. The garlic. You can't have goulash without a little bit of that garlic. Whew. I just put a little extra wood on the fire, getting a little smoky. Mix that garlic in. Don't hang me. I fucked up. I forgot. Even Wrench makes mistakes. Okay, so this is what we're looking like here after about 2 hours. I mean, that meat's ready to just kind of fall apart. So now we're coming, this is the last step. We got tomatoes, and you can use canned tomatoes, but you know, we are going in for that old school. So we are going to use fresh quartered cherry tomatoes. That's going to go in here. We're going to let that go just about another, I would say, 20 minutes for those tomatoes to kind of soften up, cook down a little. And we're going to have a finished product. Going on, we are back. Pulled it off the grill. There's what we got. We're gonna put that over some sweet dumplings. This, let's get a bite.
Yeah, it says right next to every half pound fresh, and it's just a disc. Yeah, that's fine. This is a red next to every carrot. That's a border band, so red next
to. Meat, fork tender, taste. Slightly spicy, that red pepper on the front, a little bit of the garlic, nice beefiness. It's definitely how I remember growing up. Get on there, like, comment, subscribe.